This is my a short video I'm just doing on the trip I've had in Sydney. And I've been in Sydney from the 21st of December through the 26th of December. Well, I'm actually leaving tomorrow to return to Brisbane again. I just wanted to provide some feedback about the transport in Sydney and getting around in Sydney, because the main reason I did choose to come to Sydney at this time of the year was just to have a total break from driving and to be able to test, if it may, the actual means of getting around Sydney. And I would like to score the public transport system in New South Wales as probably 7 out of 10. The trains do run quite regularly. I would give them a tick. The ferries run quite regularly. I'd give them a tick. I think the buses, though, I would have some reservations with them. I tried to get, for instance, from Wynyard out to the University of Sydney. I wanted to go out and have a look at the University of Sydney and just see what was going on with the RFIDing and the library, and just to see what the University of Sydney was like in terms of the University of Queensland. But unfortunately, I just found I could get to Central Station by train, but beyond that, the bus system was really, really bad. There were all I was told by the transport authorities was the only buses that would go to the University of Sydney from Central were all buses running in with starting with the letter 4. But anyway, I just felt like it was overwhelming, and getting on the bus I might end up getting lost or something. So I had to, unfortunately, jettison that plan. And I did travel to see family today from Wynyard up to Gosford. The train service was quite good. I noticed that Sydney has trains with a silent carriage. Usually on the first and the last carriage are silent carriages. So that is good to see, that this is actually an accommodation made for those of us on the spectrum. But I think that I would say to anybody that's visiting Sydney that, and I would give a tick to the Menzies Hotel in Sydney, is that it's very accessible in Sydney. If you really want to come to Sydney and you want to avoid noise, traffic, congestion, the total overwhelming sense of being in the build-up areas, that being close to Circular Quay and being on the bus, train and ferry routes are a good way of getting around. And I've found that the ticketing system is good. But I have some concerns about this Opal card that's coming out. Now, some of us are on a disability pension, and the Opal card, I don't know how the Opal card is going to work for people that are on a disability pension. Now, for example, I have a Go card in Brisbane. What about if I have an Opal card from New South Wales? If I come to Sydney, for example, can I have an Opal card, and will it, when I use, say, the bus, train or ferry service, will it allow me concession? How do I know that it will, I'm being charged concession rates? I think it's excellent that in Sydney you can get around on a pension card for $2.50. I went to Manly, I've been to up to Gosford, I've been out on the ferry services. It's a really good way. I really give the New South Wales government, I would give them a big tick for this actual initiative. $2.50 to get around Sydney, Greater Sydney, is really a really big bonus. And more, the New South Wales government has to get people more out of cars and start to really work on this transportation system, because it's not a bad system. It just needs some tweaking and some tweaking. I mean, it needs some tweaking, and it would be very efficient. But I would like to give some feedback about the ferry to Watson's Bay, for example. I actually caught another ferry out to Watson's Bay. I walked around Circular Head I think the paths there need to be refined. They need to be gone. They're a bit dangerous. I think, if anything, I think the walkway is up to the point up to the south head are good, but I would start to have a look at the grading. I don't know why in Brisbane and Sydney you have these stupid slippery tiles, that these slate tiles. When it rains, it is extremely dangerous. These tiles are not safe, and if you wear the wrong type of shoes, it's easy to have a slip. And believe me, if it does happen, it's not a very comforting experience. But I don't want to go too much into that. It's been a great time here in Sydney, and I think Premier Baird and the New South Wales government and the Australian government or whatever, there is a lot of opportunity here in Sydney to get the NDIS and improve services for those people with disabilities. But I would also just like to say that there needs to be sort of more areas where, you know, it just say, I don't know what it is with Australia, but if you really need to use the bathroom, for example, or whatever, you know, there's often not very many options available, but I don't want to get too much into that. But I really think there's a lot of potential here to get people with disabilities being able to use the public transport system here and getting people out of cars. And I look at Sydney, for example, which has $2.50 for a concession card. I still have one on me, and I'll just get that out briefly. I'm on my last one now. The New South Wales government are phasing these cards out, and they're going to be phased out in the 1st of January. My concern is, I really hope with this Opal card that you're going to, that's going to work, it's going to be able to perform, because I don't really know if I can see it at the moment. But I think on a scorecard, this is a great system. Brisbane, you still are overcharging. You know, it's even on a pension rate to get a city cat around Brisbane, it's $4.30 and upwards. That's ridiculous. There has to be something. And I think this Labor government that got in, instead of being dysfunctional, try and get off your butts and do something about it. I think the Lord Mayor's trying to do something about it. But anyway, I really would like to say that my experience in Sydney has been a good one. I've enjoyed the means of getting around. I've been able to use the bus, trains and the ferries, particularly the ferries and trains, not so much the buses. And it's, you know, every 6 or 7 minutes is a train that leaves from Wynyard out to Circular Quay or wherever. It's a really good system. I really think you're doing a good job with the trains. And I think the ferries are quite good as well. But there just needs a little bit of modifications made in some areas. And for anybody that wants to know more about getting around Sydney and wants some feedback, and this is for overseas visitors as well, I can recommend some really good tips for you. So if you want to know how to get around Sydney and you want to avoid all the tourist traps, and you're on the autism spectrum, you're a parent of someone on the spectrum, or something like you're an adult or whatever, you want to get in touch with me, I can provide you with advice, because I've tested these networks and I know where they're good and where they're bad, and I know how to, you know, get around to provide some advice. So thanks very much for watching. It's Christmas Day here. A Merry Christmas to everybody. And I hope 2016 will be a lot more productive than this year. And I certainly hope to be able to get a lot more things happening for adults, because there's just a lot more improvement that needs to happen, a lot more support and services. And I know that they're different for everybody, but there's a lot of work to happen in 2016. And I'm hoping to start getting the ball rolling with that as soon as possible. So thanks very much for watching.